Results, they have come in weaker. We know that financial and capital markets out there have been performing fairly lacklusterly for a number of years now. Certainly in the first half of the year there was an improvement, but that second half seems to be a real dampener for ASX. We've got that underlying profit down 2.7% overall. Is this a reasonable outcome in your view, considering the performance of capital markets?
I think this result came in a bit below expectations. As you mentioned, the second half was particularly difficult. We've seen market conditions hit particularly badly in the second half of the full year. And we did see that fall in net profit. It came in around $339 million. I think the market was looking for something a bit over $340 million, so a touch below expectations. But really, the momentum is against ASX at the moment. They're definitely facing those difficult market conditions. Revenues from both primary and secondary market services have been lower. We've seen, there's all week sort of new issuances, capital raisings have been slow, seen cash market trading volume slow. Derivatives have been a little more resilient, but given the lower volatility we've seen in the past week in markets, futures trading has been lower as well. And really, if you just look at the equity volumes traded on the ASX at the moment, in August so far, only $3.5 billion, just above that, is being traded on average each day in the market. Now, that's a huge, almost 50% down on sort of past average volumes of up over $6 billion a day. So that really highlights how slow equity markets have been. And it really is both retail and institutional investors that have been shying away from risk appetite at the moment. And that's really weighing on the results. While they are very leveraged to a turnaround in market conditions, consensus could be a little bit optimistic for full year 2013. So certainly still more headwinds to come for the ASX.
Yeah. Yeah, let's just talk about Wesfarmers and the expectations there. Tim, of course, there's always a comparison between the Coles division of Wesfarmers, its performance in relation to Woolworths. Just talk us through some of Wesfarmers' other areas of interest, notably its coal businesses, because we are still expecting a full-year profit of some $2.13 billion. Is this, I guess, when you take into consideration some of the struggle that we've seen throughout Australia's entire coal sector and industry, how is this likely to fare into those numbers?
Well, we're looking for a full year net profit after tax of around $2.13 billion for Wesfarmers today. That'll be up 11% year on year, and earnings before interest and tax looking to the consensus in the market around $3.62 billion. And that's that net profit's to increase up from around $1.9 billion for the full year last year. And as mentioned, it will be interesting to see the breakdown in segments. There has been a lot of talk about coal. Their coal division is what, in particular, it's going to be the cost pressures that we're seeing in those spaces at the moment. That's across resources in general. Costs are rising significantly in those sectors, so that will be interesting to see what they come out in terms of cost pressures. But also we'll be looking at Coles. Certainly price inflation, deflation outlook and commentary will be of interest to the market. We saw a relatively strong fourth quarter for Coles recently, certainly more higher deflation than expected. So the market will be looking at that and certainly how that's affected their margins. Like-for-like sales were quite strong, but overall sales were affected by that deflation. While we should see a bit of an increase in the second half of 2012 for both profitability and margins for Coles. And certainly looking at the discretionary sectors, we're looking at Bunnings, again, deflationary pressures there as well. Target had a good fourth quarter, so certainly we might see a surprise on the upside in terms of their discretionary businesses. Wesfarmers not big on giving detailed outlook or guidance. They usually do give some indications into their business segments, so we will get a little bit of indication from there. But certainly Wesfarmers versus Coles in terms of Coles versus Woolies. Coles has been outperforming Woolies. Woolies to result is expected next Friday, I believe, and we're looking for around a net profit of around $2.2 billion for Coles. Certainly Wesfarmers' performance has been quite good recently over the past quarter, up around 7%, outperforming the broader market. Certainly supported by investors looking for some more defensive assets as well as a strong dividend yield.